गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
ओके, इन लास्ट लेक्चर इटसेल्फ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट यूनिट एंड वन टॉपिक आई हैव गिवन यू एज अ केस स्टडी, दैट इज अ जीना केस स्टडी। एंड इन गूगल क्लासरूम यू हैव टू अपलोड द प्रेजेंटेशन प्रिपेयर्ड बाय यू ऑन Gina case study, and today is the last day to upload it. Okay, so I am happy that 38 students from your class have uploaded within a time limit. Still 38 students are remaining. So there is a time today itself who have still not done, complete it by today and upload it. So before starting with our second unit, I request anyone who have uploaded the presentation will explain about this. So, okay, Shajal, you can start. You just tell me, I will go with the next slide then. Okay, start.
Ma'am, Gina is a case study which provides an example of how a team applied the data analytics. Means how to analyze the life cycle of different phases of data analytics. There are total 6 phases of data analytics. First, discovery. Second, data preparation. Third, model planning. Fourth, model building. Fifth, communicate result. And sixth, operationalize. In discovery, the team learns. There are key points: learning the business domain, framing the problems, and identifying the key stakeholders. And in second phase of data preparation, they are preparing the analytics sandbox, performing ETLT, and learning about the data. And data conditioning means cleaning the data and normalizing data sets. And survey and common tool use for data preparation is Hadoop and Alpaline. Now third phase, that is data planning. In data planning, model selection is done, and then data exploration and variable, select key variables and most suitable models. And common tools used is R, SQL. And it ensures that the analytic techniques, single model or a series of techniques. And in fourth phase, it executes the model which is already defined in the phase 3. And it develops data sets for training, testing, and production, etc. And in phase 5, that is communicate result, it determines if the team is succeed or fail in its objectives, and communicate and document the key finding, and assess if the result are statistically significant and valid. And last, operationalize. It is risk is managed. In this, risk is managed. Team execute the algorithm and monitor the model accuracy. बस मैम।
ओके, आपने एक बहुत अच्छा एक्सप्लेन किया शाजल लाइफ साइकिल के बारे में, लेकिन इसमें जीना के बारे में थोड़ा ज्यादा अगर आप बोलोगे तो दैट विल बी बेटर, बिकॉज यू हैव टू डू द केस स्टडी स्पेसिफिकली ऑन जीना एंड हाउ जीना इज वर्किंग इन सिक्स फेज, बट स्टिल यू हैव डन अ गुड जॉब। ओके सेकेंड जो है, सेकेंड जो है हम आर स्टार्टिंग विथ या समृद्धि. हैव यू एडेड एनी जीना और इज इट अ सेम डन बाय शाजल और डिड यू एडेड मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन जीना हियर?
No, ma'am. I added life cycle.
Okay. Shubhali?
Yes, ma'am.
Had you added some more information about Gina in your presentation?
Ma'am, I have made presentation for Gina only. I have not okay. added data science, life cycle of analytics.
Okay, good. So I'm just opening your presentation. So give your presentation. Okay, so you can start.
Okay. So GINA basically stands for Global Innovation Network and Analysis. It is one of the foundation which is formed in 2012. Ma'am, next slide. Found in 2012, it is a team of the senior technologists which is located in the different world, around the different geographical location of the world. So basically, it is formed to know that all the research which is happening around the world should be known to each and everyone. And suppose one of the person is doing that research again, so he or she should know that this is already done and the data required for that is available around the world. So for that purpose, this organization is formed. So its basic plan was to create a data repository which contained the both structured as well as unstructured data. And for that, they are having the three main goals. One is store formal, informal data, that is structure in structure, then track the research around global technologies and mine the data for the patterns and to improve the team operation and strategy. And second slide. So this GINA case study basically worked to see how the data analytics life cycle takes place. So in this life cycle, we are having the six phases: discovery, data preparation, modeling and planning, model building, communication, communicate result, and operationalize. Ma'am, next. So in discovery, I founded that the team that the data for this falls into two categories, that is innovation roadmap and data representing the innovation and research. Firstly, the innovation roadmap. Here, all the data which is from the previous 5 years of the research has came into this. And second one represent the current ongoing research around the world. So for this, the hypothesis are in the two format, descriptive analytics and predictive. Descriptive means which will done on the data which is present in innovation roadmap, and predictive will do the future analysis of data. Now next slide. So here the team of the working team has been founded, which is having the project manager, project sponsor, and business user. And then they are also required a business intelligence analyst, which is again from.
Hello, Shubhali, you are not audible. Hello.
So the ma'am, from where a list of roles on working team? Hello. The list of the people which is working in GINA team. So firstly, there is business user, project sponsor, and project manager, which are from the CTO office. Then business intelligence analyst is required, which is from IT background. Then data engineers and data administrator, again, they are from IT background. and then data scientists are required to discover, to develop the social graphs which will show the Jina case study. And next slide. And next slide.
I have moved with second phase. It's not visible.
No, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, for data preparation, second phase is data preparation. For that, they have set up the IT department, which will work on the analytics sandbox. So, like, as the data is in the huge format, it across the world. So, for that, they are requiring the analytics sandbox to store and experiment the data. Then, data scientists and data engineers. If it is not up to the mark, then they will start to do the cleanliness over the data and make that data sufficient for the project being undertaken. Now, the model planning. Once the data preparation is done, data is normalized and up to the mark. Now they are going to do the modeling. That is the third phase. In that, the parameter and the scope which are scope they are planning. Firstly, they mark some milestone to achieve their goals. Suppose for a particular project they wanted their data, so up to that they mark their milestone. Then trace how the people moves idea from each milestone. Whether the people are doing the things in right order or not, they map that. And once this done, trace the ideas that and then that makes a journey to check whether the ideas is up to the mark or not. Next slide.
Yeah, moved. Thoda sa shared time lagta hai. Aapke side mein dikhne ke liye kiya hai.
Yeah.
Is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am. Now they are going to build the model. Then here Jina team works with several analytics method. This include the data scientist. Here the role of IT engineers come into the picture. They are doing the NPL, that is natural language processing over the data which is present, which they got from the previous 5 years. And then by using the R and R language and R studio, they visualize the data in the different forms and represent it. Then next.
Yeah, next slide kiya hai aayega.
So this is the graph. It shows the ideas. A submitter and a finalist. So this is basically the build in R studio by using the R language. Each of this represent an innovator from different companies. This show the relationship between the idea submitted within the Jina and a hub represent a high person connectivity between them. So like how they are going to communicate between the Jina, that is shown in that graph. So next, the communicate result. Once the graph is formed, now they are going to communicate that result around all the members which are there in that process. So they promote the data and knowledge among all the members, hidden innovators among the Jina, and get the new topic for more development in the field of data science and big data. So the last phase here, key findings are done, needs more data deployment was not really discussed, but the key findings are done. They come to know that some data is very sensitive. Data needs the infrastructure, proper infrastructure, and there are many mistakes in the data. And in this way, they are continuously evaluating the model of the deployment. Done, ma'am.
Okay. Fantastic, Shubhali. Done wonderful job. I hope everyone understood, like Gina case study, you have to focus more on only the Gina topic, okay? Not on life cycle. Life cycle is a part of it, but you have to explain each and every life cycle in accordance to the Gina case study. I hope everyone have understood, and not understood, then again, it's okay, because you yourself have to done the case study. And for that, I have told you, like, from where you will find out the book. I hope, Shubhali, you have done it from the book itself, right? Whatever the book I have uploaded, yes, on my blog. Okay. So yes, other student, I also ask you to go on my blog. I already told you where you will find out the book for this particular subject. And in that, you just go on the case studies of Gina. Just understand whatever written. It's hardly 2 to 3 page. Understood it, and then you make the presentation. So you will understand that topic by yourself. So now we'll start with our second unit. So second unit is all about data analytics. In that, second unit is basic data analytics method. So we're going to see, in first unit, we have only seen what is mean by big data, what is mean by data analytics, how the big data is generated, what are the types of big data, what is the life cycle of data analytics, that's it. Now from second unit, second, third, and fourth, these three units are mainly basically depend on what are the different analytical methods that we can use to perform the data analytics. So in that, this is a syllabus. So it is divided again into two part. First part is your statistical methods. Here we are going to study all the statistical methods required for data analytics. That is a hypothesis testing, difference of mean, Wilcoxon rank sum test, type 1 and type 2 error, power and sample size, and ANOVA. So these are all statistical method, how they are going to apply on data and what is the use of that methods. And in second part, it is actually a algorithmic base, that is advanced analytical theory and method, where we are going to study the clustering, overview of clustering. A K-means is the one algorithm used for clustering, its use cases, the method overview, determining the number of clusters, diagnostic, reason to choose, and caution. So we are going to study only the clustering in detail in second part. So in fourth unit, we are going to go with the next method, like classification, regression, likewise. So in every unit, you will find out 2 to 3 methods which are used for data analytic purpose. So in this unit, first we will start with the statistical method. So anyone from you, can you tell me what do you know about the statistics? Kya hota hai? Statistics matlab kya hota hai? Whatever you have understood about, or whatever you know about the statistics, first tell me, so I can understand, like, what, how much knowledge you are having for this topic. So I have to start from very basic then.
Mathematical analysis.
Okay, very good. It is a form of mathematical analysis. Good. Or kuch? मैथमेटिक्स और स्टैटिस्टिक्स ये सेम होता है या ये डिफरेंट होता है? क्या डिफरेंस होता है?
डेटा रिप्रेजेंटेड इन ग्राफ.
ओके. यस उत्कर्षा.
कलेक्टिंग एंड एनालाइज न्यूमेरिक डेटा.
ओके वेरी गुड. मींस कलेक्टिंग अ डेटा एंड देन एनालाइजिंग अ डेटा. ओके Himangi.
Oh, ma'am, whole data representing in a simple way.
Okay, representing a whole data in a simple way. Okay. और कोई add करना चाहेगा statistics ये word के बारे में? अगर कुछ पता रहेगा आपको तो उसके बारे में elaborate कीजिए ना कोई.
Ma'am. Numbers that have been collected in order to provide information about something.
ओके प्रोवाइडिंग सम इंफॉर्मेशन उसके लिए जो हम डेटा कलेक्ट करते हैं. ओके गुड. एनी अदर. आई वॉन्ट एवरी वन टू पार्टिसिपेट. वॉट एवर यू नो अबाउट द स्टैटिस्टिक्स जस्ट टेल मी. ओके डन. और किसी को कुछ बोलना है? ऋतुजा ऋतुजा.
यस मैम. इट इज यूज्ड टू रिव्यू द डेटा. मींस होल डेटा इज रिव्यू एनालाइज एंड रिप्रेजेंटेड इन फिगर और मींस इन स्टैटिस्टिक वे टू इजीली अंडरस्टैंड इट.
ओके. आपको आप लोगों को स्टैटिस्टिक्स का कुछ पार्ट हुआ है 11th 12th या फर्स्ट ईयर में?
यस मैम हुआ है.
ओके. क्या था मतलब उसमें?
मीन मोड मीडियन.
वेरी गुड. मीन मोड मीडियन गुड. और
लीनियर अलजेब्रा
डेविएशन एवरेज
रिग्रेशन.
लीनियर. ओके लीनियर रिग्रेशन गुड. और
ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन.
ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन वेरी गुड. ओके okay that means you know what is mean median. So this topic you know basically. Then you know what is mean by regression. Regression ka graph aap logo ko pata lega kaise plot kiya jata hai and what is a formula for regression, right? Okay, so you know some basics of statistics. Lekin statistics ko jaane ke pehle sabse important cheez which comes before the statistics is called as the hypothesis. So how many of you heard about hypothesis and what you know about the hypothesis? Hypothesis word suna hai?
Ma'am, assumptions.
Very good. Okay. Hypothesis is a one kind of assumption. Okay, good. Or ओके ठीक है. दैट्स इट. वेरी गुड आंसर. सो आई विल स्टार्ट विथ आवर फर्स्ट पार्ट हाइपोथेटिकल हाइपोथेसिस टेस्टिंग. बट बिफोर दैट यू शुड नो व्हाट इज मीन बाय हाइपोथेसिस. सो हाइपोथेसिस इज एन एजुकेशनल गेस. आप कुछ तो गेस करते हो. जैसे एग्जाम्पल आप पहले गेस करोगे कि अरे पर्यूषण चल रहे तो हाँ टू थ्री डेज का वैकेशन मिल सकता है हम लोगों को. हर साल मिलता है तो हो सकता है 3 or 4 days का वैकेशन हमको ये वीक में मिल सकता है. सो दैट सम काइंड ऑफ गेस यू हैव डन. अब ये गेस जो आपने किया है ये आइदर ट्रू होगा या फॉल्स होगा. सो कोई भी जब हम गेस करते हैं द गेस कैन हैव अ टू आंसर्स. आइदर इट इज अ ट्रू और इट कैन बी अ फॉल्स. बट फॉर दैट यू हैव टू टेस्ट योर गेस. ओके यू हैव टू वेट. यू हैव टू test your guess. So hypothesis is an educational guess about something in the world around you. Jo real hai uske bare mein aap kuch to guess karte ho. But it should be testable. Aisa kuch guess nahi karna hai jisko aap test nahi kar sako. Okay, it should be testable either by experiment or observation. So you can perform an एक्सपेरिमेंट. बट सम गेस ऐसे होते हैं जिसको आप एक्सपेरिमेंट नहीं कर सकते. आपको सिर्फ ऑब्जर्व करना पड़ता है. बाय जस्ट डूइंग एन ऑब्जर्वेशन यू कैन टेस्ट द गेस. एग्जांपल जैसे यहाँ पे अगर हमने डाले हैं लाइक अ न्यू मेडिसिन यू थिंक माइट वर्क. देखो अभी कोरोना वायरस का हर एक कंट्री कुछ ना कुछ मेडिसिन निकाल रहा है. ओके बट किसी का मार्केट में चलेगा किसी का नहीं चलेगा. किसी का टेस्ट प्रॉपर परफॉर्म करेगा किसी का नहीं करेगा. सो एनी न्यू मेडिसिन इज कमिंग. सो फर्स्ट थिंग द गेस डन बाय द पॉपुलेशन इज ओह इट विल वर्क. देन यू हैव टू टेस्ट दैट मेडिसिन ऑन सम ऑफ द पीपल और एनिमल एंड देन यू विल एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट वॉट एवर द गेस यू हैव डन दैट इज राइट और रॉन्ग ट्रू और फॉल्स हुआ है या नहीं हुआ है. So that is one example. Second example is a way of teaching you think might be better. ये एक example मैंने दिया. जैसे जो वे में मैं टीच कर रही हूँ, ओके, ऑनलाइन वे में, जिसमें हम पीपीटी को थोड़ा इंटरेक्टिव बनाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, एंड आई एम थिंकिंग ओके द टीचिंग मेथोडोलॉजी दैट आई एम यूजिंग इट माइट बी अ बेटर, बट आई डोंट नो बेटर है कि नहीं. ये मुझे कब पता चलेगा? आई हैव टू टेस्ट इट. टेस्ट कैसे करूंगी? आई कैन टेक अ फीडबैक फ्रॉम यू और आई कैन आस्क सर्टेन क्वेश्चन ऑन यू, या फिर मैं चेक करूंगी कि स्टार्टिंग में जितने स्टूडेंट जो ज्वाइन थे वो अभी भी ज्वाइन है कि नहीं. जैसे अटेंडेंस देते वक्त 60 स्टूडेंट थे, अभी हमारे खाली 53 स्टूडेंट 54 स्टूडेंट बचे. सो आई हैव टू चेक आउट कि भाई ये 5-6 जो स्टूडेंट है, इन लोगों को शायद ये स्ट्रेटेजी समझ में आ रही है, नहीं आ रही है, नेटवर्क इश्यू, व्हाट एवर इट इज. सो आई हैव टू चेक इट. सो जो भी आप स्टेटमेंट कर रहे हो, जो भी आप गेस कर रहे हो, यू हैव टू चेक ऑल दैट गेस बाय यूजिंग सम एक्सपेरिमेंट, एंड यू हैव टू टेस्ट इट whether whatever you have done the assumption, वो assumption true है या false है, ये आपको उसमें guess करना पड़ता है. So there are some steps of doing the hypothesis testing. So the steps are, very first stage is making an assumption called hypothesis about a population parameter. अब population क्या होता है, sample क्या होता है, हम जब next lecture नेक्स्ट टॉपिक देखेंगे उसमें ये सब डिटेल में आएगा. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप खाली ये होती है कि आप कुछ तो अजम्पशन करो, जिसको हम क्या बोलेंगे, हाइपोथेसिस से. तो स्टेप वन इज टू परफॉर्म द अजम्पशन. सेकेंड स्टेप, जो आपने अजम्पशन परफॉर्म किया है उसको आपको चेक करना है राइट है कि रॉन्ग है. वो चेक करने के लिए अभी आपको कुछ ना कुछ सैंपल डेटा कलेक्ट करना पड़ेगा जिसको आप टेस्ट करोगे. ओके, सो फॉर चेकिंग द सैंपल डेटा, सेकेंड स्टेप. Then step three is calculating a sample statistics. जो आपने sample data collect किया है उसके ऊपर आप कोई ना कोई test perform करोगे. So there are lots of many tests of statistics like t-test, p-test, z-test. So ये हम कुछ अलग अलग test हम इसमें check करने वाले हैं. So just by applying that test on your sample data, you will calculate some statistics. कुछ mathematical statistics आप calculate करोगे. And just by calculating that statistics and after finding the result, you will check अगर वो result कुछ threshold के नीचे है या ऊपर है. अगर result threshold के ऊपर है, so you can say that your hypothesis is right. And if it is less than whatever you have consider the hypothesis, consider the threshold, उसके अगर नीचे जाता है तो आप बोलोगे कि जो हाइपोथेसिस है वो क्या हो गया, आपका फॉल्स हो गया है यहाँ पे. सो देर आर फोर स्टेप्स ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस टेस्टिंग. फर्स्ट वन इज मेक द हाइपोथेसिस, मतलब एक स्टेटमेंट बना दो. सेकेंड, उस स्टेटमेंट को चेक करने के लिए आप कुछ सैंपल डेटा कलेक्ट कर लो. थर्ड, जो आपने सैंपल डेटा कलेक्ट किया उसके ऊपर कोई हाइपोथेसिस टेस्टिंग का कोई एक टेस्ट परफॉर्म करके उसको उसका आप स्टैटिस्टिक कैलकुलेट करो. एंड जो आपने स्टैटिस्टिक कैलकुलेट किया है उसको आप इवैल्यूएट करो एंड देन डिक्लेयर दैट व्हाटएवर द गेस यू हैव डन दैट गेस इज राइट और रॉन्ग. सो दीज आर द फोर स्टेप फॉर दैट. देन नेक्स्ट इज व्हेनेवर एनी प्रॉब्लम इज कमिंग योर माइंड,